Altai Mountains. Altai Mountains, Russian Altai, Mongolian Altai Nuruk, Chinese Altai Shan, complex mountain system of Central Asia extending approximately 1,200 miles, 2,000 km, in a southeast-northwest direction from the Gobi to the West Siberian Plain, through China, Mongolia, Russia, and Kazakhstan. The jagged mountain ridges derive their name from the Turkic-Mongolian Altan, meaning golden. The system has three main subdivisions, the Altai proper and the Mongolian and Gobi Altai. A peak in the Altai proper, Beluka, at an elevation of 14,783 feet, is the range's highest point. In the past, these mountains were remote and sparsely populated, but in the 20th century they were open to extensive resource exploitation, and the ancient ways of life of the local peoples had been rapidly transformed. Physical features. Physiography. The Altai proper lie in the Altai Republic of Asian Russia, in extreme eastern Kazakhstan, and in the northern tip of the Xinjiang region of China. A belt of northern foothills separates the Altai from the West Siberian Plain, while in the northeast the Altai border the western Sayan Mountains. From Naramatlan Peak, with an elevation of 14,350 feet, near the point where the borders of Russia, Mongolia, and China meet, the Mongolian Altai extend to the southeast and then to the east. The Western Mongolian Altai form part of the border between Mongolia and China. The Gobi Altai begins some 300 miles southwest of Ulaanbaatar, the Mongolian capital, and dominate the country's southern portions, towering over the Gobi expanses. Geology. The Altai were formed during the great orogenic upthrusts occurring between 500 and 300 million years ago and were worn down, over geologic time, into a peneplain. Beginning in the Quaternary period, new upheavals thrust up magnificent peaks of considerable size. Earthquakes are still common in the region along a fault zone in the Earth's crust. Among the most recent quakes is the one that occurred near Lake Sasan in 1990. Quaternary glaciation scoured the mountains, carving them into rugged shapes, and changed valleys from a V to a U-shaped cross-section. River erosion has also been intensive and has left its marks on the landscape. As a result of these differential geologic forces, the highest ridges in the contemporary Altai, notably the Khatun, North Chu, and the South Chu, tower more than 13,000 feet, 4,000 meters, in elevation, running latitudinally in the central and eastern portions of the sector of the system within the Altai Republic. The Tavan Bagdoola, the MNH Aranyul, and other western ridges of the Mongolian Altai are somewhat lower. The highest peaks are much steeper and rockier than their alpine equivalents, but the ranges and massifs of the Middle Altai, to the north and west, have ridges of about 8,200 feet, whose softer outlines betray their origins as ancient, smooth surfaces. Valleys are nevertheless jagged and gorge-like. The ridges are separated by structural hollows, which are filled with unconsolidated deposits forming steppe landscapes. Elevations range from 1,600 to 6,600 feet above sea level. The extreme dislocation suffered by the Altai over the course of geologic time have occasioned a variety of rock types, many of them altered by magmatic and volcanic activity. There are large accumulations of geologically young, unconsolidated sediments in numerous intermontane depressions. The tectonic structures bear commercially exploitable deposits of iron, of such non-ferrous and rare metals as mercury, gold, manganese, and tungsten, and of marble. Climate. The regional climate is severely continental, because of the influence of the Great Asiatic Anticyclone, or high-pressure area, the winter is long and bitterly cold. January temperatures range from 7°F in the foothills to 26°F in the sheltered hollows of the east, while in the Chu steppes temperatures can plunge to a bitter 76°F. There are occasional tracks of the permafrost that coats great stretches of northern Siberia. July temperatures are warm and even hot, daytime highs often reach 75°F, sometimes up to 104°F on the lower slopes, but summers are short and cool in most higher elevations. In the west, particularly at elevations between 5,000 and 6,500 feet, precipitation is high, 20 to 40 inches and as much as 80 inches may fall throughout the year. The total decreases to one-third the amount farther east, and some areas have no snow at all. Glaciers coat the flanks of the highest peaks, some 1,500 in number, They cover an area of roughly 250 square miles. Drainage. The Altai proper and the Mongolian Altai are crisscrossed by a network of turbulent, rapid rivers fed mainly by melted snow and summer rains, which occasion spring and summer floods. The Khatun, Gutarmek, and Biya, all tributaries of the Obi River, are among the biggest. Rivers of the Gobi Altai are shorter, shallower, and often frozen in winter and dry in summer. There are more than 3,500 lakes, most of structural or glacial origin. Those of the Gobi Altai are often bitterly salty. Plant life. Four fairly distinct vegetation zones can be discerned in the Altai: mountain sub-desert, mountain steppe, mountain forest, and the alpine regions. The first, found on lower slopes and in hollows of the Mongolian and Gobi Altai, reflects the high summer temperatures and low rainfall. The sparse life includes xerophytic and halophytic plants. The mountain steppe zone rises to about 2,000 feet in the north and to 6,600 feet in the south and east. Meadows and mixed grass steppes are characterized by sod grasses, forb species, and steppe shrubs. The mountain forest zone is most characteristic of the Altai proper. It covers about 7/10 of the territory, mostly in the low and medium mountain regions. Forests reach up to elevations of 6,600 feet but climb to about 8,000 feet on the drier slopes of the central and eastern Altai. Most prevalent are coniferous species, larches, firs, and pines, but there are also large areas covered by secondary birch and aspen forests. A forest belt is practically non-existent in the Mongolian and Gobi Altai, but isolated clumps of coniferous trees grow in river valleys. Alpine vegetation. Subalpine shrubs giving way to meadows widely used for summer pasture and then to mosses and bare rock and ice, is found only on the highest ridges. Animal life. Animal life follows vegetation patterns. Various rodents populate the mountainous semi-deserts and steppes, while bird life includes eagles, hawks, and kestrels. Most species are of Mongolian origin, example marmot, gerbonwin, and antelope. Siberian mammals and birds frequent the moist coniferous forests. Alpine animal life includes the mountain goat, snow leopard, and mountain ram. Geography. Central Asia's landscape can be divided into the vast grassy steppes of Kazakhstan in the north and the Aral Sea drainage basin in the south. About 60% of the region consists of desert land, the principal deserts being the Karakhan, occupying most of Turkmenistan, and the Kazilkan, covering much of western Uzbekistan. Most of the desert areas are unsuitable for agricultural use except along the margins of the Amu Darya and Sir Darya river systems, which wind their way northwestward through Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan, and eastern Uzbekistan and Turkmenistan after rising in mountain ranges to the south and east. Those two major rivers drain into the Aral Sea and provide most of the region's water resources, though northern Kazakhstan is drained by rivers flowing north into Russia. On the east and south, Central Asia is bounded by the western Altai and other high mountain ranges extending into Iran, Afghanistan, and western China. Check out us for more videos. Do not forget to subscribe our channel.